from Miami, Florida, ladies and gentlemen, Ricky Santana.
Big action right here with the great Muta coming to the ring, followed by Gary Hart. Here is an incredible story. This young man out of Japan, the Pearl of the Orient, as Gary Hart calls him, undefeated in the NWA. Now, you're talking about some rough competition. I don't care who you are, to have a record like this, you have got to be something very special. He's a fellow that they've talked about as being the heir apparent to the Japanese heavyweight crown. And across the ring from Miami, Florida, another rather unusual story. Ricky Santana. Here's a young man that came to the United States with his family at the age of 2. And all of his family now are American citizens. His father left. Whoa, look at Muta. Takes him right through the ropes and down on the floor at the very beginning of the bout. Passing up Gary Hart, and Hart passed up the opportunity to nail him. He doesn't do that all the time, only when he figures that it is imperative that it come about. Back into the ring rolled Ricky Santana. One of the interesting things that we were looking for in this match is Santana, a speed merchant of his own, goes under that roundhouse kick. Cover 1, 2, and that's all he got. Santana with a beautiful drop kick. He must have heard us, because that's exactly what he's showing, that speed that everybody has earmarked this young fella as being a definite comer in the NWA. Gary Hart to have a talk with Muta. Don't take him too lightly. There's no way in the world that you're going to be able to get by this young man without quite a scrap. Referee Tommy Young backing Santana up. Ricky ready to get him back in the ring and to have him go at it again. He had some momentum going, and Hart stalling out there to kill off the momentum that Santana had. Whee, back to the ring, apron rather, and into the ring for the action. It's the great Muta, repeating again, and it bears repeating, undefeated in the NWA. Ricky Santana, we were telling you, is, you see Santana again. He's a little too quick out underneath that leg. Boy, he can whirl it around from everywhere. It looks like he's got 8 legs sometimes, because he can hit you from any spot. Tied up, collar and elbow, little side there. And Santana takes him down into a headlock, but not for long. You are going to see blazing speed from both of these contestants in there. Santana, in case you just joined us, with his back now to you, and there, without a question, the great Muta, face painting, and he is quite a sight to take a look at. Waist lock from behind, and Santana back into the corner. The referee will call for a break. Tommy Young, the referee for this match, as Ricky Santana gets one from the Muta. Can you believe that move? He came out with that mule kick, doubled, went right down and popped back up. Takes him over and down, holding into a side headlock on the mat. The great Muta, he almost looks with that paint on his face like he absolutely is a mask himself. Unusual attire around that face with the writing all over it. Ricky Santana now trying to shake him. He does. He catches a shoulder. Over the top goes Muta. Look at that guy. He has such tremendous grace, and Ricky Santana hooking into an arm bar. Very tight right up at the shoulder. Hanging in there. Santana, who is cutting his teeth now and gotten himself into contention here, at least where he is facing some of the major majors. What a story, as we said. His father left Cuba when Fidel Castro came into power, brought his family to the United States, and is now, all of them are sitting, look at that headstand, back up to the feet, takes it over, snaps the leg. Santana with a bad leg now. He'll go for it again. This time, he springs it back the other way with a spin that adds the flourish. The Great Muta snaps him over and down and slips in behind. Reverse face lock. He's got him chin locked from behind. The referee checks to be sure that he's not down on the throat. Muta looking over at manager Gary Hart, puts the fingers in the mouth and goes to the eyes. You saw the spray mist early on as he came out in the beginning. Something about the way he puts his fingers in the mouth gets that mist, the residue of it, on his fingers, and then he'll go for the eyes. You'll see it again right now. Has the hands up to the mouth. Santana needs to move it. He is looking for a way out of this, but Muta crowds him into the corner. This guy is bigger than you would think. Talking about 6'2 and a half, 6'3, Muta is, and he is so finely built, he's deceptive when you look at him. Ricky Santana choked over that top rope. Gary Hart giving him some hand signals down there. Muta looking for the opportunity to put one of those killer moves that'll end up in a victory. Takes a couple of shots and then with that full 360 spinning back kick, catches Santana in the body with enough force to knock him down. To the mouth again. Now he goes for the pressure point. Whoa, he can do it with that. Let me tell you, you've seen a lot of guys use pressure points, but never with the vengeance that this Great Muta can go at. Moves from underneath the arm right up to that pressure point by the trapezius muscle. Takes him hard down on his knees. The Great Muta looking for a win. Santana not ready to go out yet. This young man, a lot of heart. He didn't battle his way into the position that he's at now by going out on the first trouble. The Great Muta hanging on to that pressure point. Gary Hart signaling at ringside, wants him to put it to him. As Ricky Santana feebly takes a shot at him, whipped across the ring to full. Split all the way into the corner, and Santana gone, still has that natural speed working for him. Muta shakes his head, takes a shot to the midsection. Santana follows it up, turning it around. Now on the whip, he backdrops Muta off the rope. Ricky Santana picking up some of the excitement of the crowd, grabs Muta by the hair, slams his head into the turnbuckle, moves in on top of him, and Ricky Santana has done a complete 180 now and in control on Muta, something you haven't seen too many of them do. Pounds him in the corner. Referee Tommy Young gets him off. Another whip across the ring and into the corner, but too late. Muta himself, there is a belly to back, takes him over. 1, 2, 3 with a great bridge from Muta. And that son of a gun was a move that I had. The Great Muta went in right in behind him after he had gotten out of the way of the effort to be mashed by that shoulder from Santana. Slipped in behind with a belly to back and used the suplex as the method supplemented by that bridge. Let's take a look at it. Here was the mistake. Santana to the corner. Watch Muta. Spins around. Sees the opportunity. Belly back. Takes him straight over and watch the bridge. The winner, the Great Muta.